Hi students, good morning to one and all. Welcome to Vignan Digital Classes. Students, we are discussing Rayaptics chapter. We completed two videos on Rayaptics. We discussed the introduction of Rayaptics and we completed the reflection phenomena. Today, we continue the discussion of Rayaptics. Especially in Rayaptics chapter, we continue the Rayaptics, and today we would like to talk about refraction. The second phenomena of Rayaptics is refraction. So we will discuss about the Rayaptics, this refraction phenomena of Rayaptics. So let us move on to the contents in this Rayaptics chapter. So in today we talk about the refraction. In that refraction, the contents that we would like to discuss one by one, the contents that we would like to discuss in Rayaptics chapter are: the first content is refraction of light. What is the definition of refraction? What is the phenomena of refraction? Second one, the principle of reversibility of light. In showing the refraction phenomena, we observe the principle of reversibility of light through refraction. So we will discuss about that principle of reversibility. Next one is refraction through a parallel slab. Refraction process through parallel slabs. Next one is the lateral shift. In the extension of refraction through parallel slabs, there is a lateral shift as well as longitudinal shift. So the longitudinal shift is discussed in apparent depth of a liquid. So this is also known as the longitudinal shift due to refraction phenomena. Next one is total internal reflection. One very good application of refraction is total internal reflection. We will talk about the total internal reflection and then applications of total internal reflection. We are using total internal reflection in so many cases, such as the optical fiber. Just we mentioned the applications of total internal reflection, and problems belongs to this apparent depth, real depth, refraction through parallel slabs, and the principle, the phenomena of refraction, the phenomena of refraction. We will talk about the Snell's law. So we will do the problems belongs to Snell's law and speed of light in different medium, and apparent depth, real depth. So we will do some problems belongs to these concepts. So let us move on to the first definition of refraction of light. So the refraction of light. Here, first one, refraction is the phenomenon of change in the path of light. So the change in path of light, change in the path of light. Refraction is the phenomena of change in path of light as it travels from one medium to another medium. So we observe the light traveling through different medium during its propagation. Light may travel from air medium to water medium, or water medium to air medium. Light may travel from air medium to glass medium, or glass medium to air medium, or sometimes there are composition of so many mediums. So while traveling from one medium to another medium, when light is traveling from one medium to another, we observe the change in path of light. The phenomenon of change in path of light when traveling from one medium to another medium. Refraction is the phenomenon of change in path of light as it travels from one medium to another medium. This is possible due to change in speed also. So this is known as the refraction. Simply, change in path of light as it is traveling from one medium to another medium is known as the refraction. So let us consider, it can also be defined as phenomenon of change in speed, change in path caused by change in speed. If the medium of the light through which it is passing changes, as medium changes, speed of light also changes. This is also considered as the phenomenon of refraction. Here, To know about the refraction schematically, let us consider the situation. Let this be the a medium. This blue color graph indicates, this blue color image indicates a medium of refractive index mu as drawn there. Now this is the denser medium. Let it be having more refractive index than the surrounding medium. More refractive index medium is called as denser medium. Let this blue image be the denser medium having more refractive index. The either side of this one is rarer medium, like air. Generally air is a rarer medium. If you consider this one as a glass slab, obviously it becomes a denser medium with more refractive index. Here let us consider the path of light ray. So students, for your convenience, I am showing the animation once again. We incident a light from air medium, from rarer medium, then it passes the denser medium, then it passes through a rarer medium. So let us look into the path of light ray through all these mediums like that. So first light started in rarer medium, enter into the denser medium, then enter into the rarer medium. Like that the medium is changing, then path of light also gets changes. Observe the diagram. The light doesn't travel along the same straight line path, it simply changes its path. Like this change in the path of light ray, as it is moving from one medium, rarer to denser, or denser to rarer, change in path of light ray is known as, this phenomenon is known as refraction. So let us draw the normals, students, let us observe the normals. This is the point of incidence at which light is incident from rarer to denser. Let us draw a normal line with dotted line. Similarly, here the at this point, light is traveling from denser to rarer. Here draw the one more line, one more dotted line is drawn at this point of incidence. Okay. These are the point of incidences, and normal lines are drawn with dotted line at that point of incidence. Here we are representing angles. Angle made by incident ray with normal is angle of incidence, let it be I. This is known as the refracted ray. This one is incident ray, this is refracted ray. Angle made by incident ray with normal is angle of incidence. This is the refracted ray in the second medium, denser medium. Angle made by this refracted ray with normal is angle of refraction. This R, angle of refraction, is represented by the R. Then it emerges out from denser to rarer medium. This is the second refraction. Here the first refraction takes place at this point while it is changing from rarer to denser, and it continues its propagation while it is traveling from denser to rarer. One more refraction has taken place. For this, this is the angle made with normal R, and this is the angle made with normal, that is I. Now this change in path of light ray as medium is changing is known as the refraction phenomenon. Here loss of refraction. After knowing the diagram, let us come to the loss of refraction, the first one. Here in the diagram you are observing one thing. This is incident light ray, this is refracted light ray, normal drawn to the interface. Incident light ray, refracted light ray, and normal, these three lies in same plane. So incident light ray, normal to the refracting surface at the point of incidence, and the refracted ray, these three lie in same plane. This is the first law. Comes to second law. Here we have a given pair of rarer and denser medium. Let them be air and glass, for suppose. Consider given pair of rarer and denser medium as air and glass. For this given pair of medium, for a given pair of medium and for given light, the ratio of sine of angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction is constant. This is Snell's law. For given pair of medium as shown here, rarer and denser, and for given light of certain wavelength incidenting, the ratio of sine of angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction, I is the angle of incidence, R is the angle of refraction.
the ratio of sine of angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction, sine I by sine r is constant. So this is the equation. Sine I by sine r, this must be constant. This ratio is constant. This is the second law. Ratio of sine of angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction is constant. It is also, of course, that constant is also equal to refractive index of the refractive medium with respect to the first medium. This ratio is constant. Moreover, a constant is equal to refractive index of the refracting medium, refractive index of the refracting medium with respect to first medium. So mu 2 by mu 1. So the constant is called refractive index of the medium with respect to the first medium. Here I is known as angle of incidence, r is known as the angle of refraction. Then sin I by sin r is equal to refractive index of the refractive medium with respect to the first medium. So these are about the laws and basic. So far I explained the phenomena of refraction with a diagram followed by laws of refraction. In second law, we studied about the Snell's law. The ratio of sine of angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction is constant. This is the statement of Snell's law. So let us have some tips of this refraction. While refraction is going on, there are some tips. Refractive index of optically rarer medium is lower and that of denser medium is higher. For example, compare the glass and air with respect to water or air with respect to air. Glass is a denser medium. Glass is a denser medium. Optically, glass is a denser medium. So relatively, with respect to air, glass has more refractive index. Hence, glass becomes denser medium with respect to air. Similarly, with respect to glass, air has less refractive index. With respect to glass, air has less refractive index, hence air is the rarer medium. So optically rarer medium such as air having lower, optically denser such as glass has more refractive index. And then mu of denser medium with respect to rarer medium is more than 1. For example, refractive index of glass with respect to water is always greater than 1. Refractive index of glass with respect to water, refractive index of glass with respect to air is always greater than 1. So refractive index of denser medium with respect to rarer medium is more than 1, and as well as in reverse, that of refractive index of rarer medium with respect to denser medium. So refractive index of air with respect to glass, refractive index of air with respect to glass is less than 1. So refractive index of rarer medium with respect to denser medium is less than 1. So for air or vacuum, the refractive index is considered to be 1. Next is one. In refraction, the velocity and wavelength of light changes. Refraction means as light is traveling from one medium to another medium, as medium changes for the light ray, then path of light ray changes. This phenomenon is refraction. Suppose when light is traveling from the air medium to glasses medium, its path changes as explained. During this, velocity changes as well as wavelength changes. Velocity, wavelength, path of light ray changes. Velocity of light also changes, wavelength also changes. Suppose if light enters into any denser medium like glasses medium from rarer medium, let us consider a simple example of light traveling from air medium to glass medium. That is considered as light is traveling from rarer medium to denser medium. Then the changes are light path changes, so it considered to be bending towards normal, r is less than I, as well as speed reduces, wavelength also reduces. So when light is traveling from rarer to denser, to understand it, let us consider light is traveling from air medium to glasses medium. Light bends towards the normal, as well as speed of light reduces, wavelength that also reduces. And in refraction, frequency and phase of lights do not changes. Frequency of light doesn't changes, phase of light also does not changes. Here we write a general formula that refractive index of a medium with respect to air is equal to refractive index of any medium. Let this medium be glass medium or water medium or any other medium with respect to air is equal to speed of light in air to the speed of light in medium. So in this way we calculate refractive index. Refractive index of any medium with respect to air is speed of light in air medium by speed of light in a given medium. So we write a general formula that refractive index of second medium with respect to first medium. Let light be traveling from first medium to second medium. Light is traveling from first medium and enters into the second medium. As medium changes, mu changes, it path changes, speed changes, wavelength changes. These are the consequences in refraction. Then refractive index of the second medium through which it is entering with respect to first medium mu 2 by mu 1 is equal to sin I by sin R, where I is the angle of incidence, R is the angle of refraction, which is also equal to V1 by V2. V1 is the speed of light in first one, V2 is the speed of light in second one, which is also equal to lambda 1 by lambda 2. This is the very, very important formula, belongs to this refractive index and related with speed, related with wavelength, related with angle of incidence and reflection. This is very generalized expression for us. Suppose light is traveling from medium 1 of refractive index mu 1 to medium 2 of refractive index mu 2, then mu 2 by mu 1 is sin I by sin R, that is Snell's law. It is also equal to V1 by V2. As frequency is constant, V is equal to n lambda is the general formula. As n is constant, V1 by V2 is also equal to lambda 1 by lambda 2. So it is a general formula. So next one, principle of reversibility of light. So to know about the principle of reversibility of light, let us consider this animated image. Let this be a denser medium. This white color one shown in this animation, you are observing this white color one is a denser medium having refractive index mu. The outside of it we have a rarer medium. A is the rarer medium in the diagram, B is the denser medium. Let us consider light ray traveling from rarer to denser. Here we kept a mirror. Here we have a mirror. So once again we kept a mirror on denser medium. Let us allow the light ray to travel from rarer to denser first of all. So let us consider the light ray. This is the light ray traveling in rarer medium. This is the interface, refracting surface, and at this point of incidence light enters into the denser medium, and this is the light ray changes its path and traveling in the denser medium. Let us draw the normal. Now this is the normal, and let us see the incidence angle. This is the angle of incidence I, angle made by incident ray with normal, angle made by refracted ray with normal is angle of refraction. So let us have the incident angle and refracting angle. Now this is the incident light ray enters into the denser medium, so it comes closer to the normal, angle of refraction is less than angle of incidence, then it continues its path and incident on the mirror. From the mirror, here this is a mirror, let it be incident on the mirror, and from the mirror it reflected back. You are observing arrow mark. The light ray reflected back from the mirror and traveling along the same path. Now light ray travels from denser to rarer. In the reverse direction, reverse path of motion of light, now it incident at this interface at R value. Here it incident at interface, here actually it refracted at angle of refraction R while traveling from rarer to denser. After reflecting from mirror, it come back along the same line. Now R becomes the angle of incidence for the reverse direction, I becomes the angle of refraction. Now it is in reverse direction after reflecting from mirror, it is traveling from denser to rarer medium. Then R becomes the angle of incidence in the reverse direction, I becomes the angle of refraction.
Here we are observing the refractive index to know or to conclude the principle of reversibility of light. Let us conclude it by using an expression form. While light is traveling from rarer to denser medium, then refractive index of denser medium with respect to rarer medium, refractive index of denser medium with respect to rarer medium is mu ba. That is given by sin A by sin R with respect to Snell's law. Now, after reflection from the mirror, it travels from denser to rarer. Then refractive index of rarer medium with respect to denser medium in the mu A by mu B. This becomes the R becomes incident angle, I becomes angle of refraction. Then refractive index of rarer with respect to denser mu AB. Mu AB is equal to sin R by sin A. Now, just multiply these two equations. On LHS, mu BA into mu AB is equal to sin A by sin R into sin R by sin A. They cancels in numerator and denominator, it becomes 1. So therefore, the product of these two, refractive index of B with respect to A into refractive index of A with respect to B, this product becomes 1. Okay. Or on cross multiplying, refractive index of B with respect to A is reciprocal of refractive index of A with respect to B. While it is traveling from rarer to denser, we use this formula, refractive index of B with respect to A. In the reverse direction after reflection, it is traveling from denser to rarer. Then we find refractive index of A with respect to B. Then refractive index of denser medium with respect to A is equal to reciprocal of refractive index of rarer medium with respect to denser medium. So if ray of light, so this is principle of reversibility of light. If ray of light after suffering any number of reflections like as shown in diagram and refractions has its path reverses and at any stage it travels back to the source along the same path. Suppose light travels from A here and reaches point B and reaches some point C. At C it reflected. First it goes refraction, then undergoes reflection. From C it reflected back, then undergoes refraction. Then it may comes to A once again. Here it reaches A. So A is the source actually, and refraction takes place in the denser medium, and reflection takes place at C. Then reflected ray come back and undergoes refraction, and it reaches source. So during the path of light ray, principle of reversibility explains that during path of light ray, traveling of light ray, after having refractions or at any stage it undergoes reflection, then it come back and reaches the source. So it travels back to the source along the same path in the opposite direction. It travels back to the source A. See, it travels from A to B, then B to C. After reflection it travels from C to B and B to A. So after reflection it travels back along the same path and reaches the source. So a natural consequence of the principle of reversibility is that the image and object positions can be interchanged. So we know that this is object actually, this is the image, and these are reversible. If you kept the object, image is formed here. If you kept object, image is formed here. If A is considered as the object, image becomes C. If you kept the object at C, image becomes A. Image forms at A. Like that, object and image are exchanged. So here the image and object positions can be interchanged. Image and object positions can be interchanged. Hence this is known as the principle of reversibility. Let us move on to the next one, refraction through a parallel slab. We completed refraction. We wrote expressions for refraction phenomena with the help of Snell's law. We discussed the principle of reversibility. Let us move on to the continue the discussion of refraction applications, refraction through a parallel slab. So let us consider a parallel slab. This yellow color one is a parallel slab. Let this parallel slab in yellow color be a denser medium such as a glass having a refractive index mu. It's surrounded by a rarer medium at the top, and at the bottom there is a rarer medium. Now let us consider thickness of the slab. History, this is the important derivation object to exams. Thickness of the slab. Here one more time, I am drawing the same thing. to represent more clearly. So thickness of the slab from top to bottom is T. So let us have path of light traveling. Here this is the yellow color one, is the incident light ray, and it undergoes the refraction in denser medium, so that path of light ray changes. Blue color ray is the refracted ray in the denser medium, and then it emerges out from the denser medium to rarer medium. This is emergent ray. Okay, incident ray, refracted ray and emergent ray. This is the refraction process going on from rarer to denser, followed by denser to rarer. So let us consider, extend the actual incident light ray. So let us see, this is the incident light ray. I would like to extend the incident light ray. I shown the extended line of incident light ray by dotted line. Actually, if there was no denser medium, light would be traveled along the same direction. Light would have traveled along this direction if there is no denser medium. If medium does not change, light would have traveled along this direction. But practically there is a denser medium present in the path of light, hence these changes takes place. Therefore, it emerges like this. Therefore, this is the emergent ray, light ray, and this is the incident ray. There is some distance between incident ray path and emergent ray path. There is some gap between, distance of separation between emergent ray and incident ray. And this distance is the shift. Here we would like to know that shift. Here at each interface, I draw the normals. So this is the first normal drawn at the top surface, and this is the second normal drawn at the bottom surface of denser medium. And with this red line, I am representing y. This y is the lateral shift. Lateral shift, students. Actually, this is the incident ray. It would have traveled along this line in the absence of this denser medium. But in the presence of denser medium, due to the phenomenon of refraction, light emerges out along this line. This is the actually happened one. And then there is a distance of separation between the actual emergent ray and extended direction of incident ray. This perpendicular distance between these two lines is known as the lateral shift. The change in the directions gives the lateral shift, let it be y. Here we have to find out that lateral shift value in this derivation. Here let us write the values. While it is traveling from rarer to denser medium, angle of incidence is I1. This angle of refraction is R1. Next, here angle of incidence is I2. Let us assume this angle of, while it is traveling from denser to rarer, this angle of incidence is I2 and refraction is R2. Right? And we have to find the deviation, angle of deviation. Angle of deviation is the angle between the refracted ray and incident ray. This is the refracted ray, this is the incident ray, this is the extended line of incident ray, this is the refracted ray. So in the denser medium, the angle made by the refracted ray with the direction of incident ray is known as angle of deviation, let it be delta. Here we are introducing a new term, angle of deviation. That is the angle between extended line of incident ray and refracted ray, that is lambda. That lambda is known as the angle of deviation. Of course, this angle of deviation delta becomes, this is I1, so this is also equal to I1 minus R1, I1 minus R1, this total value is I1, and subtract the angle of refraction. So I1 minus R1 is considered as the angle of deviation, very important. If I1 is the angle of incidence in, let it be, rarer medium, R1 is the angle of refraction in denser medium, then I1 minus R1 becomes the angle of deviation. Okay. Let us move on to the derivation part after a clear explanation of the phenomena of refraction. So refractive index of this is B, denser medium, with respect to A, rarer medium, according to Snell's law, sin I1 by sin R1. And similarly, while refraction is taking place from denser to rarer in second interface,
for the emergent ray, refraction is taking from denser to rarer. Then refractive index of A with respect to B, refractive index of A with respect to B is sin I2 by sin R2. For second refraction, I2 is the incident, R2 is the refracting angle, sin I2 by sin R2. Here, multiply them. According to principle of reversibility, that's what we discussed in the previous part of our discussion in this session, the product of these two must be 1. Refractive index of B with respect to A and refractive index of A with respect to B. Refractive index of A with respect to B is reciprocal of this value. Hence, they cancel each other. This product becomes 1. Already we proved it. Therefore, replace mu BA by the Snell's law equation, sin I1 by sin R1. Mu AB by Snell's law equation at second refraction, sin I2 by sin R2. And we know that I1 is not equal to R1 because I1 is incident angle, R1 is refracting angle. I1 not equal to R1, but this product is 1. Then this is possible if and only if I1 is equal to R2 and I2 is equal to R1. So that's what I conclude. So this product is 1. It implies that I1 must be equal to R2 and I2 must be equal to R1 as I1 is not equal to R1. I1 is R1 when there is no change in medium. As medium is changing and refraction is taking place, path is changing its direction, then I1 doesn't equal to R1. Hence, I1 must be equal to R2 and I2 must be equal to R1. Here, so I1, this R1 equal to, let us observe what I explained here. This I1 is the angle of incidence while light is traveling from rarer to denser. And second case, it is traveling from denser to rarer. And this R2 is angle of refraction. R2 is angle of refraction. We conclude from that expression that I1 is equal to R2. So, when it travels through slabs or number of slabs, a light started in air medium and passes through number of slabs kept one after another and finally it may emerge out. Then, angle of incidence in first air medium must be equal to angle of emergence when finally it comes to the same air medium. Ultimately, it comes out, emerges out and passes through the same air medium. Here this is air medium and this is air medium, rarer and rarer. Then incident angle and emergent angle are equal. And inside this slab, R1 is equal to I2. So outside this slab, the I1 is equal to R2. That's what we conclude here. Next, we would like to find out lateral shift. Already explained, the perpendicular distance between the emergent light ray and extended line of incident light ray, this perpendicular distance is known as the lateral shift. And we have to derive the expression for lateral shift. For that, let us consider tan delta in this right angle triangle. We have right angle triangle by having 90 degrees at M. So, in this case, we have a right angle triangle. This is one point of incidence. This is another point of incidence. And with these two points of incidences as well as with M, between these two, we have a right angle triangle. We have 90 degrees at M. And take tan delta, where delta is angle of deviation. Tan delta is equal to, consider tan delta here. The tan delta is equal to, tan delta is equal to y divided by opposite side by hypotenuse. So let this point be A and this is B, then hypotenuse is equal to AB, y by AB, tan delta. So let us consider the sin delta, for example the sin delta, not tan delta, let us sin delta. Sin delta is equal to opposite side y by hypotenuse is AB. So let this be the equation 1. Then to find this AB value, consider cos R1. Cos R1. Cos R1 here is equal to adjacent side by hypotenuse. That is T divided by hypotenuse is equal to AB. This implies 1 by AB
is equal to T by cos R1. So replace 1 by AB in equation 1 by T by cos R1. Hence we find the sine delta is equal to Y into 1 by AB. So Y into T divided by cos R1. Here we have to find Y value. On cross multiplying we get the value. So 1 by sine delta is this Y divided by AB, and cos R1 is adjacent side divided by hypotenuse T by AB. 1 by AB is T by cos R1. Sometime sine delta is equal to Y into 1 by AB is T by cos R1. On cross multiplying we write the expression for Y value here, and we find out Y by the formula. So sine delta is opposite side Y divided by hypotenuse, that is AB, one equation. Second equation is cos R1, adjacent side T divided by AB. Then 1 by AB is equal to, here 1 by AB value is cos R1 divided by T. So let us, cos R1 is equal to cos R1 divided by T. So replace the sine delta. Now the sine delta becomes, sine delta is equal to Y into 1 by AB is equal to cos R1 cos R by T. So on cross multiplying Y is equal to T sine delta, that's what I write here, T sine delta by cos R1. So we find the lateral shift. Lateral shift Y is equal to T sine delta divided by cos R1. So let us extend the formula. Already I explained that the delta is equal to I1 minus R1. So T sine I1 minus R1 divided by cos R1 is lateral shift. If angles are very small, sine of that angle is same angle, cos of that angle is 1. So we write sine of I1 minus R1 is I1 minus R1 and cos R1 is 1. So that Y is equal to T into I1 minus R1. Hence this is about the refraction through a rectangular slab and lateral shift expression in that one. So let us move on to the next one, that is refraction through a compound slab. We extend the explained concept. So let us observe, we have two compound slabs. One is in white color, another one is violet color. We have two compound slabs. All are denser medium. So first one is the rarer medium, air medium. With respect to that, this is the denser medium B. And with respect to this one, air medium, this is also denser medium C. We have two denser mediums, B and C, with respect to outside medium. So refractive index of the rarer medium is A, and first denser medium is B, and second denser medium is mu C, and relation between them, mu C is greater than mu B. So with respect to this B, C is denser. So it is traveling from rarer to denser, and more denser then comes to the same rarer medium, mu C greater than mu B. So let us draw the direction of path of light through them like this, and draw the normals also. So this is the incident light ray. At this interface, at this incidence, it refracted through the denser medium. So come close, it changes the path of light and come close to the normal. Further, it is traveling from one denser to more denser. This is denser, but it is traveling to relatively more denser medium. Then it comes further close to the normal at this point. Then it finally emerges out through the air medium, emerges out into the air medium. So this is the sequence. Then the angles are, here we have I1, this is R1, then this is also equal to R1. If this is R2, angle of refraction in the second denser medium, this is also equal to R2. Ultimately, if you kept any number of slabs, the final, ultimately the light ray must emerges through the final air medium with same angle. If this is I1, angle of incidence, after passing through any number of slabs, if it emerges through the air medium, this angle must be equal to I1. This is I1, this is also equal to I1. Okay, this is the refraction phenomena taking place here. Here, the refractive index of B with respect to A is sin I1 by sin R1. Similarly, refractive index of C with respect to B is sin R2 by sin R1. So, Snell's law I am using. Refractive index of C, here refractive index of A, finally it is emergent through A medium. Refractive index of A with respect to C is sin I1 by sin R2. So, like that we write the expressions, refractive index of A with respect to C. So, that is sin R2 divided by sin I1. Once again, while it is traveling from first rarer to denser, refractive index of B with respect to A is sin I1 divided by sin R1. While traveling from relatively less denser to more denser, refractive index of C with respect to B second equation is sin R1 by sin R2. While it is traveling from C to the air medium, refractive index of air with respect to C is sin R2 divided by sin I1. Then multiply them. So we know that when light ray is traveling through number of slabs kept one after another, the product of all these refractive index must be equal to 1 according to the principle of reversibility. So this product must be equal to 1. Or we write, if you multiply them, sin I1 and sin R1 cancel, sin R2 in numerator denominator values get cancelled, sin I1 get cancelled. So in the product everything get cancelled and we get this is 1. Therefore product of first 2 is equal to reciprocal of 1 by mu AC, that is also equal to mu CA. 1 by mu AC is equal to mu CA, we get it. Or mu CB is equal to mu CA divided by mu BA. So in that way we take the relations among those refractive indices. When light ray travel from one medium and travel through number of slabs, through compound slab, combination of slabs, and between them we use the from top to bottom refractive index of B with respect to A into refractive index of C with respect to B into refractive index of A with respect to T. See, the product of all these is 1. This is the main formula. From this we find any unknown value. So let us move on to the apparent depth of a liquid. So let us consider a beaker containing water. This bluish one is water kept in a glass beaker, water medium. And here we know this, this is air medium, rarer medium having refractive index mu A, refractive index of air of course numerically 1, this is air medium, bottom one is the glasses medium having a refractive index B. Let us consider a coin, an object like a coin, an object like a coin in blue color is dropped in water at the bottom. At the bottom of the water there is a coin at position O, let it be object. Now consider light rays emerges from the object. So from the object this is the light ray. At this point it is changing its medium from denser to rarer. While the light ray changes its path from denser to rarer, it moves away from normal. From denser to rarer, light ray travels away from normal. That's what happened here. Light ray doesn't extend at the same path. Path of light ray got changes, traveling from denser to rarer, so it moves away from normal. Here, this is the light ray. Consider one more light ray traveling perpendicularly to the surface. This is the surface. Light ray traveling perpendicular to surface means light ray is traveling along the normal. So angle of incidence is 0. So angle of refraction is also 0. So it move without any deviation. I is 0, R is 0. So it move without deviation in a straight line. This is the normal light ray. Light ray traveling along normal line, normal directed line. So let this be the line drawn on the surface of water. This is the interface, which is this face is interface to the denser and rarer medium. At this interface, refraction process is going on. And here, consider, suppose an observer is here, that he is observing the coil from outside. So let us consider, let this be the eye. So from this position, he is observing. An observer is here, he is looking at the coin. He is observing the coin in the beaker from outside. For him, he may undergo optical illusion that he always considers light is coming in this direction. So according to his perception, the light ray may travel from O dash. Actually, the coin is at O inside the water. Because of refraction phenomena, as light moves away from normal while traveling from denser to rarer, so according to the outside observer, with respect to this ray, he undergoes optical illusion that light traveled from O dash. Light would have traveled from O dash, but actually light started from A. But this is the difference for the actual position and apparent position. This is the O is the actual position of the coin. Because of refraction phenomena of light while traveling from denser to rarer medium, the any outside observer undergoes optical illusion and he feels that the object may be at O dash. This is the apparent position. So hence O dash is the apparent position of the object, whereas O is the actual position of the object. So here let us draw. We have to find out the relation between this apparent depth and real depth. That is our aim. Let us draw the normal line at the refraction taking place. This is the interface and this is the point of incidence of the light ray coming from denser medium. And at this incident point, at the interface, draw a normal with a dotted line. Here, from the surface, actual object is dropped and it is at position O. So, HR is the real depth. HR is the real depth. Object at O is at real depth HR. But due to refraction phenomena, for any outside observer, object appears to be at O, hence it is the distance from surface of water to this O is apparent depth. Let it be HA. H suffix A is apparent depth at which object is appears to be observing. Really it was at O, so real depth is HR. We have to derive the relation between HR and HA. That is our aim. So let us move on to the angles. Let I, this light ray is traveling here. So this is the angle of incidence of the light ray coming from the actual position of the coil. Then this is the normal at interface. Then angle made by incident ray with normal, this I. Let us see, this I is angle of incidence. Okay, this is angle of refraction. Light ray is traveling from denser to rarer. This is angle of refraction. And when you consider, these two angles must be equal, because this normal and these two are parallel lines. Between these two parallel lines, these angles must be same. This is I, as well as this is R, and we extended the refractor light ray backward to know the apparent position. Hence, this is also equal to R. These two are parallel lines. This is normal and this is also a line along the normal. And extend this, this is a parallel line, these two are parallel lines, and we extended this backwards, a straight line is drawn between parallel lines, these angles must be same, this is also equal to R. And next one, refractive index, we are applying Snell's law to have the relation between HA and HR. So let us apply refractive index of A with respect to B. Because light ray is traveling from denser to rarer, we apply at this refraction point the refractive index of A with respect to B sin I by sin R. That's what we write here. Next one, refractive index of B with respect to A. Refractive index of B with respect to A. Here, this is refractive index of B with respect to A is reciprocal. That is sin R by sin A. Okay. Now, refractive index of B with respect to A is sin R by sin I. Here let us find the values of sin R and sin I. Sin R and sin I. Let us consider this triangle. Let us consider this triangle. This is O dash. This point be A and this point be B. Let this be A and this be B. We have a clear representation. In the right angle triangle OAB, sin R, for very small angles, sin R nearly equal to tan R. Sin R nearly equal to tan R. Tan R is equal to opposite side AB by adjacent side HA. So, sin R in the right angle triangle OAB for small angles of refractions and incidences, INR approximately considered as tan R, that is equal to opposite side by adjacent side, AB by HA. That value becomes AB by HA whole divided by sin I. In the right angle triangle OAB, we have sin I. We find sin I. Sin I is equal to opposite side AB by adjacent side is equal to HR. AB by HR. So this is AB divided by HR. Therefore, sin R by sin I becomes HR divided by HA. So refractive index of B with respect to A is, if light is, any object is kept inside a medium of refractive index B, we are observing from a medium of refractive index mu A, then refractive index of B with respect to A is equal to HR by HA, that is real depth by apparent depth. Hence, this is the very essential equation for us. Refractive index of B with respect to A is real depth by apparent depth. So, we are observing any object in denser medium from outside the rarer medium. We are observing an object in denser medium with respect to from rarer medium. Then, refractive index of denser medium with respect to rarer medium is equal to real depth by apparent depth. This is the equation. Mu, suppose the rarer medium is A, then mu is equal to real depth by apparent depth. So, suppose the second one is air, refractive index of denser medium by 1 is equal to the real depth divided by apparent depth. Therefore, the apparent depth is equal to HR divided by mu in that way. So, apparent depth is real depth by refractive index of denser medium with respect to rarer medium. Apparent depth is also always equal to the real depth divided by refractive index of denser medium with respect to rarer medium. So, apparent depth of number of immiscible liquids. So, not only one liquid as discussed here, if you have number of immiscible liquids, one above another, so then the apparent depth is equal to, for single liquid, the apparent depth is, as I explained there, is the real depth divided by refractive index of that liquid. Refractive index of that liquid. So, absolute refractive index of that liquid with respect to air. So, we have number of immiscible liquids, one above another. So, above water, suppose this is one liquid, above this one you pour another liquid. Suppose this is water, you pour some oil, kerosene oil. It is not mixed with water, it is immiscible liquid, lies above the surface of water. In such cases, the apparent depth is like this, the H1 by mu1. H1 is the real depth of first liquid, mu1 is refractive index of it, plus H2 by mu2. H2 is the second liquid depth and its refractive index is mu2, plus and so on. And apparent shift, now we would like to find out the shift. So, apparent shift, actually the object is kept at bottom, which is at a real depth HR. Due to refraction phenomena, object is appears to be at O and there is a rise of the position of the object. So, this difference is said to be shift. This is shift. Let this be the delta H. This is the shift, which is HR minus HA. Shift in the position of object is real depth minus apparent depth. HR minus HR by mu. HR common, 1 minus 1 by mu. Mu always consider the refractive index of denser medium when outside is air medium. So, the shift is 1 minus 1 by mu. So, the tips to find out, if the observer is in rarer medium, so reverse case, if observer is in rarer medium and the object is in denser medium, then HA less than HR. So, to a bird, the fish appears to be nearer than the actual depth. Suppose this observer is a bird, fish is in denser medium, any bird observes the fish, fish appears to be less depth than the actual depth. Apparent depth HR is equal to H by mu. HA is equal to H by mu means apparent depth is always less than the real depth when objects are in denser medium. Therefore, for any bird, the fish appears to be lesser than the actual distance. Suppose the observer is in denser medium. Suppose fish is observing. So, let us reverse the cases. Let the observer be in denser medium. He is observing the object in the rarer medium. If the observer is in denser medium like a fish and the object is in rarer medium, then the apparent height is more than the real height. So, here simply we conclude that for any object in the rarer medium, consider an object in the rarer medium like a bird, observed from denser medium like a fish, fish is observing the bird, then the real height and apparent height must be mu times the real height. Just reverse the case, you find the answer. So apparent height for any fish inside the water observes the bird in air medium, then bird is appears to be at more height than the actual height. So HA apparent height is mu times the real height. When observed in rarer medium or observed from objects in rarer medium are observed from the denser medium. Okay. So students, in our today class we introduced the concept of the refraction. We defined the refraction as change in path of light ray when it is changing, as it is changing in the medium, path of light ray get changes. We define the refraction, we define the loss of refraction. In it, Snell's law is the very important one. Sine or ratio of sine of angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction is constant. And we observe the so many applications of the refraction, such as lateral shift as well as longitudinal shift, the apparent depth, real depth relation. Apparent height, real height relations belongs to longitudinal shift. Students, I hope you followed it very well with this a beautiful animated explanation. Thank you for hearing. Thank you, Ananda.